Welcome to this product walkthrough for Easy Agile Roadmaps. Today, we're going to walk through getting the roadmap up and running, with our key focus areas being syncing the start and due date fields for a synchronized roadmapping experience, scheduling work from your backlog onto the timeline, slicing your roadmap using themed swimlanes, and visualizing key date milestones and Jira fix versions on your roadmap. Let's get started. Before we dive straight into the roadmap, we need to synchronize our desired Jira start and due date fields with Easy Agile Roadmaps. We know that many of our customers have created multiple custom date fields like project start and end date or contract start and end date, just as a few examples. And so we require users to specify which of those date fields should be mapped directly to the roadmap schedules. It's important to note that a Jira administrator is required to map these date fields. To map these date fields, a Jira administrator must navigate to the Jira Administrator cog and click on Manage Apps from the dropdown. Down the left-hand side of the Manage Apps page, find Easy Agile Roadmaps and click Configuration. Here, your Jira administrator will need to select the desired date field under Roadmap Start Date and Roadmap Due Date. In each dropdown, you will see a list of all of the date fields available on your Jira instance. Once we've mapped our desired start and due date fields to the roadmap schedules, we must ensure that both of those fields are associated with the screens used by your teams. Once installed, Easy Agile Roadmaps can be found in the project sidebar for every Scrum and Kanban Agile board. Clicking on the roadmap icon in the project sidebar will load your roadmap for your selected board. If your Agile board has issues which have been populated with your selected date fields, you'll notice that they appear on the timeline in a swimlane called Issues Without Themes at the bottom of your roadmap. We're now going to walk through the elements you're seeing on your screen. Lining the top of our roadmap is our timeline. At the moment, we can see we're viewing our roadmap on a monthly timescale. To change the timescale of the roadmap, click on the ellipsis menu in the top right corner. From the dropdown, we have the option to view our roadmap on a weekly, monthly, or quarterly timescale. Below our date headers are our theme swimlanes. Theme swimlanes are a flexible way of grouping work and breaking up the roadmap in a more visually digestible way. Themed swimlanes can represent anything suitable for your business context, from distinct themes of work to project components or even teams. On first load, you'll notice two themed swimlanes present on the roadmap. The first is an example swimlane called My Theme, which can be renamed. The second is a swimlane called Issues Without Theme Swimlane. The Issues Without Theme swimlane is pre-populated with any issues on your backlog with populated date fields. These issues can be dragged and dropped into any of your theme swimlanes. To create a new theme swimlane, click the Create Theme button located at the top of the roadmap. Name your theme and press Submit. Your new theme will appear above the Issues Without Theme swimlane and can be reordered using the arrows to the right-hand side of its name. Issues from your board that have not been populated with start and due date fields can be found in the Issues panel. Click on the blue Issues button in the top right corner of the roadmap to open the Issues panel. Clicking on the Options button will display a drop-down of all the available issue types from your board. And checking the box next to an issue type will load all of the issues from your board of that issue type into the panel. To schedule an issue onto your roadmap, simply drag it from the Issues panel onto the timeline. Issues can be resized to show their expected start date, duration, and end date. To resize an issue, drag the left or right end to its desired date. The start and end dates will appear above the issue when it's dragged for more accurate planning. If you've synced your date fields, the issue will automatically be populated with the scheduled start and due date fields in Jira. Any updates to those fields in Jira will also automatically reschedule the issue into its correct schedule on the roadmap timeline. Jira versions can also be visualized on the timeline. To add your Jira fix versions to the timeline, select the markers button from the top of the roadmap. Here, you'll see a list of all available fix versions for your board. Under the action heading, select Add Marker to the versions you would like to visualize on your roadmap. A version marker will appear red when it is past the version's release date and it has not been released on the releases page in Jira. A version marker will appear blue when it is not yet past the version's release date and it is still in progress. Versions released on or before their release date will appear green on the timeline. Moving the version on the timeline via drag and drop will update the version start and release date in Jira. Date markers are a flexible way of representing milestones or events such as conferences, beta periods, or marketing campaign launches as a few examples. To create a date marker, select the markers button from the top of the roadmap. Select the option Add a date marker. Here, name your date marker or milestone. Set the start date, and optionally set the end date, and choose a marker color. Colors can be used as a visual way of distinguishing types of events. For example, yellow could signify campaign launches, while blue might represent upcoming trade shows. You can reschedule your date markers by either drag and drop or by clicking on the marker to open the Edit Marker dialog. The roadmap can be exported to PDF to share with users who don't have access to Jira. To export your roadmap, click on the ellipsis menu and select Export to PDF. Select the time frame you would like to share using the start and end date pickers and press Export. This brings us to the conclusion of this walkthrough for Easy Agile Roadmaps. For any questions, please feel free to reach out directly to our support team. We look forward to hearing from you.